count on. NBC2 News at 6.
If you've been on social media today, I'd bet you've already seen it.
So what is ProfilePic.com and why is it so popular?
So everyone who's following the trend of going online onto an app and it draws pictures of saved photos.
It may sound harmless, but tonight there's worries that Russian hackers could get access to your face and photos as soon as you upload them to the app.
New concerns over new ProfilePic.com tonight. It's the app that's sweeping social media feeds all over the world. The app takes photos like these and turns them into canvas paintings like these. But tonight, there's a concern that the app contains dangerous Russian malware. I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. So are hackers from halfway around the world really stealing your data and your face with the app? Or is this just a bunch of hype? Tonight, NBC2's Dave Elias is separating fact from fiction.
Well, the app is called the new Profile Pic, and it works like this. You center up your face, and you snap a picture. In seconds, it looks like a work of art. The concern, though, is the artist behind the painting.
Me and my work bestie were just playing with this app.
Ellie Jostin creating artwork.
Well, I did all of them.
Of her six-month-old son.
I am the cutest baby ever.
The pictures filling up Facebook feeds.
And I saw a lot of my friends from like high school and family posting photos of themselves in this like portrait sort of like painting mode.
It's the artist behind the artwork though who's raising concerns.
And everything I found out is seems like a Russia hack. Getting personal information from Americans.
After the Daily Mail reported the app was created in Russia.
Initially, it showed that they were registered in Russia, in Moscow. This has quickly changed now to Florida.
Checking Sunbiz, I found no company named Line Rock Investments operating in Florida.
Everything seems to be controlled by this Anderson Business Services, which is still registered in Russia.
Cybersecurity expert James Ritter warns the app, like many, could be collecting data.
It is scraping the data from your Facebook account.
While there is no evidence of anything malicious, Ritter offers this advice.
If you are going to download these types of apps to have fun on social media platforms, whether it's Facebook or others, maybe not use your true cell phone.
A concern for some.
Knowing this information, I definitely wouldn't venture out and like try the app myself.
However, Ellie isn't so worried.
No, I don't think I have any significance to Russia, and I think they have much bigger issues right now. So, no, I'm not concerned.
Meanwhile, the Cyber Helpline, which offers advice to online victims, says the overall trust score for this app is just 14%, so download at your own risk. Dave Elias, NBC2.